2020 quabbin season started off really rough. The Quabbin Reservoir was originally supposed to open on April 18th, but then got pushed back to May 9th. Then this was changed yet again with a notice stating that the opening of the boat launches would be delayed until further notice. It was also rumored that the boat launches wouldn't be opening up at all during the season, though many other boat launches across the Commonwealth were. With many quabbin anglers being angered by this, we banded together, including yours truly, and we contacted the state reps and the DCR and insisted mercilessly they open the reservoir. And with all the mounted pressure, they succumbed, and on May 21st, the quabbin was finally open again. When the day did finally arrive, to no surprise, the use of masks and gloves became a new requirement for launching. We complied. After all that fuss, and if that wasn't bad enough, on opening day, when it was finally my turn to launch my boat, my Mercury outboard decides to crap out. Since we didn't have the ability to go offshore for the day, we decided to salvage the morning and we worked the electric motor, never stranding far from the dock. Throughout the remaining course of the delayed season, my Mercury kept breaking down. I spent more time playing boat tag and waiting for repairs with my marine shop than I did my boat fishing. More on that later. Luckily, in between waiting, I had a few friends that let me tag along in their boats, allowing me to still have a decent season. Here's how it all unfolded. All right, it's opening day. The line's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be, but it's ultra slow. How many cars are behind us? Oh yeah, the line got huge. Wow, we pulled up, the line wasn't bad. Just getting here that 15 minutes early made a big difference.
We're running the electric near the dock. That's what we're doing right now, just to salvage the day. Turns over and starts up for like 5 seconds, 6 seconds, and then conks out. Everything was giving me a hard time. Nothing was easy today. Sucks.
After dealing with the frustration of trying to get a hold of a few marine mechanics, my buddy John calls in to tell me his Mercury broke down too. What are the odds?
Nice. Sorry. Sidetrack. It's like the second one we just hooked up with. And, yeah, if you want them, Anthony, just throw them in the line well. Yeah. But, sorry, so anyways. Yeah, no problem. I'll talk to you later. Yep, bye. He's waiting for the state to call him back. Oh.
Pretty good fight.
Big chain pickerel.
Trout of Quabbin, lake trout, lost his salmon earlier, fishing on Anthony's boat because my motor broke down on opening day. I'm gonna let this guy go now. All right, thanks, Anthony.
No, it's a lake trout, it's a nice one.
One more fish out before it's over. We got what, 15 minutes?
Yeah, about that.
The lake trout. It's number two. Alright. That's that. No boat rentals this year. There they are, all stacked up. Thank you, China. First landed salmon of the season. First one I hooked, I got yesterday, but I lost it. I got my first one today, landed on lead core. Not a bad start. We should, it's still early. Hopefully we can get into some more. I'm gonna turn around and go right back to the spot here in a moment. Hopefully they're all stacked up. To be continued. Two and a half colors of lead. It's smaller than the other one. It's a little guy, but this one actually put up a better fight. I actually thought it was bigger than what it was, but they're all fun. Just glad we're getting into them. Now it's Anthony's turn. We're about to go over the same spot where we just pulled this one over, so tight lines. Anthony just banged one out, and while we were fumbling with this fish, he got bit again. Biting good today. Nice job, man.
Thank you.
All right, just banged out another salmon. Got him on metal. This one's a male. The fin is clipped on this one, so this was a fingerling that they stocked probably a couple of years ago. The others didn't have the adipose fin clip; they were intact. So those other two were wild fish, where this male is a stock domestic fish. But it's turned wild. But nice looking, a little tiny kite. I want my friend Anthony's boat because my boat broke down. So luckily, I've got some friends that take me out. Get out of here, so appreciate it. You filming.
Awesome.
Not a bad deal. Gonna see if we can bang one more before closing time.
Yeah. All right.
When I'm bass fishing, I want bass, and when I'm salmon fishing, I want salmon. Should be more excited about that fish, but I'm not. Just banged another one out. Anthony hooked hooked up earlier, it came off, and then I got this one at the same time. Seconds after I hooked this one, Anthony hooked a nice rainbow trout. We had doubles on, it was crazy. We were trying to reel up lines and net, and it was just a mess, but we did get this one in. They're running small this year, for me anyway. It's crazy trying to reel this one up. Anthony was trying to reel up one of my other rods, and he got one on, and I'm had the self net, and I got caught up in a bunch of lines. It was challenging. I'm still gonna keep poking at it. Hopefully, we get something a little bigger. But it's a good start. Let's hope there's more.
He's a keeper. Keep him, or
I'm in a live well. Decide later whether you want them or not.
It's true.
It's the beautiful thing about the live
boat. I know. Fuck, we're already on the board.
Like a sizable one too.
He's coming.
Yeah, I'm turning the boat and I got the net in. Yeah.
That was a little bit big.
What you hear there? I'm gonna drop the boat.
Right into the net for you. Good.
Well, you're all the same age class.
Right. Here's Anthony's salmon, third one.
So Anthony got three today. We're gonna let him go right.
Nice job, Anthony.
Thank you.
Woohoo!
Three.
Unfortunately, I left my jacket in my truck. I was cold because the temperature dropped, so I ended up putting my life jacket on. Doesn't exactly look that cool, I know, but it kept me a little warmer.
Big salmon. Big sand. Woohoo!
Good one.
Beautiful sand.
Love the sand.
Woo! Yeah. Hooked. Another one that was even bigger than this that got off.
Landed this one.
Tight. Gain on them when you can.
Yep.
When you can, bring your rod tip back, yep, and then reel forward.
Yep.
So you can constantly gain on them. He's pulling, Greg. You might want to tighten your drag up here.
He's starting to come out a little bit.
That's a good one.
Wow.
That's a nice bass.
Wow, that's a real good one. Four and a half, huh?
All right, Anthony, you got a nice smallmouth today. Nice job, Anthony.
What does it feel like?
Feels okay. Feels decent. The fine line between the right amount of drag and enough to gain on it.
Yeah. Looks like a decent fish.
He doesn't want to come.
Feels pretty good, huh?
Come in, grab the net, and watch the wheel. Right here.
Like that?
Yep.
He's going to turn to the right shortly.
Oh my God, he does not want to come up.
A good fish. Fish on there, then you...
A giant! He's pretending to be.
To the left a little bit more. There's the weight. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready.
Oh, it's a huge salmon! Holy Jesus!
Oh,
wow!
That's a giant!
I knew he was a good one.
Wow!
Oh, that's a real salmon.
That's a nice one.
Beauty. Nice one.
Yep.
Sweeties.
Five and a half, six maybe. Yeah.
Four and a half, five pounds. Yeah. That's what I came for.
There you go. I knew he was pretty good size.
Yeah, he's fighting good. See how careful you got to be with them, though?
Yep. He never jumped.
All I could think about, it's because I kept my rod tip down. Yeah. He wanted to jump.
Yeah.
I kept, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice to see them jumping. The aerials are awesome to view, but you also risk losing them. Earlier, I banged out this 26-inch 410. Could be a little bigger. I think my scale's off a little bit, but it's a nice 26-inch fish. But at least 4 pounds, 10 ounces. maybe a few ounces bigger. What a beautiful specimen. Gave me a hell of a fight. We're gonna try to let it go right now. Is it a neutral?
Down to that deep water, that colder water, it'll be all right. It was okay. Need another 5 pounds on it, but.
Early morning sand. Coming right in, which is making me nervous. He might go berserk when he gets near the boat.
Yeah, it's a laker.
Well, it could be a laker. You want to cut the wheel a little more to the left?
What?
You line it up. I'm starting to feel its weight now. A lot of line out on this one. Just fighting them now.
Decided to wake up?
Yeah. Salmon.
Yeah. Nice one.
We got a salmon. Woohoo!
Cut to the left a little bit.
Yep.
Close to one.
Goes. Going deep.
Dead.
Great fight. Think it's going circles.
There he is.
Nice. Looks like a good one.
I don't know what position you should get into until it's a bit closer than what it is. This is a good one.
Really good one.
Blind and then.
Just walk back.
Well, I will once I get up to the way. Pray to God, it's so bright. I lost a monster the other day, but it wasn't hooked right. We're getting close. All right, let's get there. Lift out. It's a good one. That's a fucking good one.
That's a trophy, dude.
That's a trophy. Nice one.
Eagle marks on them. A little black mark and an indent right there. Beautiful male.
Nice.
Check it out, the adipose fin was clipped.
Yep.
That was awesome. That was worth getting up.
Yeah.
It's right here. You might want to get that net.
I'm doing it.
Wow, he's deep too. You extended yet? Let me know and I'll tighten up on this. Turn the boat to the left, please. Okay. We're ready to land this bad boy. I'll get it to the weights off. Glide it in as best as I can. It'd be interesting trying to do this.
There we go. Jesus. Woo! Damn.
What?
Salmon number two.
Woohoo!
John got a nice one, close to five, if not five. I think my scale's a little off. It's a fatty. Nice pig. I'll let it go right now.
There you go. There you go.
There you go.
There you go. Double thumbs up.
Doing some bass fishing today.
Crush that bait, man.
John and I were having a great morning slamming smallmouth, but then his motor crapped out on him again. The state police were friendly and were kind enough to give us a tow back. Ironically, both of us were going through the same issues, going back and forth with our marine shops only for our mercs to temporarily work until they died again. Let's just say neither John or I are fans of mercury. And by the way, here's a dirty little secret you may not know. Since 1987, all small mercury motors, 30 horses and under, are actually manufactured by a Japanese company called Tohatsu. Which on the Quabbin is relevant when you consider the max is a 25 four-stroke and a 22 stroke. Fed up, we both bought new Yamahas. To go with the new motor, I finally bit the bullet and bought a new boat. I've been wanting to upgrade for a while now and it just seemed like the right time. She's all sealed up and ready to go. 2021 season, here we come. In case of any new regulation changes, I was reviewing the new 2021 Fishing and Hunting Guide. I was pleasantly surprised to see my mug again on this year's Sport Fishing Awards promo on page 17. Every year I like to participate in their program. Congrats to all the other winners as well. Beer or water? Well, it's Friday after work, so I'm going with the beer. All right, folks, let's see. Looks like opening of the 2021 Quabbin season is still slated for Saturday, April 17th, which is good. It's a tentative date. It's not carved in stone, but I don't imagine that they're gonna change that date. With restrictions loosening across the state, I'm feeling pretty confident that the opener won't be delayed again this year. Plus, when they did finally open up the boat launches last year, I don't recall anyone getting COVID from launching their own boat. I think we're gonna be all right. If you would like to see even more Quabbin and outdoor content, please visit my Instagram page. The link is down below within the video description. If you do visit, please hit that follow button. Also, while you're already here in YouTube land, please help support my efforts and hit that subscribe and like button. And last but not least, good luck to all of you this season. It won't be long now. And I'll see you on the water soon. Be safe. And cheers.